Grand Rising, you guys. Happy Sunday. Today I'm about to put the kids on some chocolate chip pancakes. I'm gonna throw it inside the oven. These are already made, already cooked pork sausages. You just put those inside of the oven as well. And while that's cooking, I'm gonna go inside and do my meditation. And we will see you guys later. Also, you hear the water making a sound. The reason why you hear that water is because I need to stop up the sink because I was running the water and then stop it up. But this is the pot roast that I'm going to be cooking for dinner. And we will see you guys later. You guys, do not throw away your flowers, especially your carnations from your altar, because they also can be used in your spirit work. Red carnations are for love, passion. So these are great when you do love spell work, okay? So this is the roast. I season it with this. And your meal ain't complete if you don't have no complete. And some black pepper and some salt. So now I'm about to put the beef broth in there and let it cook in the instant crock pot. What's up, y'all? So we're at the park. You see the weather is bad, but Trinity had a party to go to at Topgolf. So I brought the girls to the city walk to play until the party is over with. Because you know it's a teenage party, so she didn't want her sisters to come in with her. So I was like, I'll just take them to the park until the party is over with at 5:30. As you guys saw, I didn't even record myself doing my dinner because I completely forgot about the party. This is the second party I forgot about this weekend because I had another birthday party to take the smaller girls to yesterday, but we were out running around getting school supplies and, you know, shoes and stuff that I completely forgot about that party. But those little ones back there running around, they're having a good time playing. And so by the time I got the meat cooking inside the slow cooker, my eye is going down a little bit. At first, I was worried about that. I was like, what is going on? It may have just been something going on with my eye. I don't know, but it's not bothering me anymore. I just been doing the cold towel on there and going from there. But yeah, so I'll see you guys. I'm gonna go ahead and close out the vlog. Today's vlog, I'm gonna end it showing you guys the food when we get home. Like I said, I put the potatoes into the slow cooker and the instant pot. So the roast and the potatoes, all of it's in the instant pot together. And I'm boiling corn. I put that on extra low. So by the time we get home, everything will be done and we can eat dinner. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace. It started raining again and right in time for us to go pick up Trinity because the party ends at 5:30 and it's 5:25. But I noticed some daffodils and I asked Serenity, could she pick me some pretty ones for me to use on Friday for the Venus, the day of love. These also can be used for luck. And I saw them on the playground, which is great because that is, you know, to bring back, you know, joyous things into your joyful love, all that stuff. That's what kids are feeling when they're at the playground. So I'm going to be using this for my self-love work. And I also noticed that she picked some that had some more like blooming at the bottom. So I'm gonna try to take those off and put those in water. Hopefully they'll still grow. But these are beautiful. All right, so we're gonna head to go get Trinity. And then we're gonna head home and enjoy dinner and take our baths. We'll take our baths and then enjoy dinner. I had a good time at the park with the girls. My glasses are smudged, so I can't even put my glasses on, y'all. So she got part too close. So I can't even put my glasses on, y'all. But I can see a little bit. Like, I'm not blind, y'all. It's just my eyes are very irritated. I told you this eye has been bothering me. So I've just been making sure that I keep it, like, a cold rag on it while I've been at home. I finished my book last night, you guys. The Butterfly Book 6. You guys, Ashley Antoinette pulled the emotions out your girl with this book here. I cried the entire book from the beginning to end. Like, she even forewarned you, like, be prepared to cry. Very, very much a lot of emotions, a lot of, she said that this was going to be the last book, and it, she said that, as you can see, these people have a lot of stories to still tell, so she cannot let this be the last book, so look forward to book 6. She's basically letting us know, like, it can be in 2 months, because she writes like that, or it can be in 2 years, but please don't rush her crap, please don't rush these stories. And I don't feel that we should, because she gave her all in this book. All of her books are dope. I love her books. I was telling my daughter, I have favorite authors that I've read all their books. Sorry, you guys, I was going over bumps. I have favorite authors that I always read their books. First and foremost, I love Zane for a long time. I didn't even know she was a woman writer. I love her books. And then I went over to Sister Soldier.
Raw salad, but you hate.
And you talking to me or you talking to the game on your phone?
The game.
Sister Soldier, she is a great writer. I waited for her books. So I'm just getting back into my book, reading my books, you guys. And to be honest with you, it's giving me more, because I'm a writer as well, and I kind of stop because my mind is always going. But to be honest with you, that's the life I live, being a Sagittarius. We're very, very creative. Our mind is always creating. That's why Sagittarius are always busy and on the go. If you know a Sagittarius, they're always like, gotta do. Our minds are consistently going on a regular, but we have a hard time finishing it. So that's why I want to make sure I keep being consistent on everything that I do. Why do my phone? I just wanted to keep falling while I was driving, shopping to y'all. But I just want to stay consistent on everything that I'm doing. So that's why I make sure I do. But I wrote a book. I have a few books that I've wrote. I write poetry. I write music. I do music. Yeah, I'm very, very, I have a lot of things that goes on in my head, you guys, and it's not no mediocre things, it's real deal, talented things. I just slow down, motherhood will slow you down, but trying to be, you know, being a wife, and then still focusing on myself.
Mommy, this person don't even like orange watermelon pear smoothie.
She don't?
He
don't?
Yes.
Well, that's probably not good to do. So I just decided to be more consistent. But yeah, getting to the reading her books. I like books, though. I'm a type of person. My daughter was telling me about an app that has creators that add their stuff every day, or they'll start the series and they'll do it every month, then they'll come back and, you know, every other month, and they'll just keep coming back. I might start my book on that. I don't know. I told her, give me the info on that. So I'll just put out a series and see how people like the books that I put out on there, and then come back. But yeah, so I've been trying to finish it up, and it's not like a, it's some of the stuff is real. Of course, it's gonna come from something, right? And then some of the stuff is just fictional. It's up to you to choose on and decide on what you want to think when you read it. So, yeah.
Our phone about to go dead.
It is. Yes. Trendy should be getting in the car in a minute. But yeah, so you guys will see that. That is something I didn't buy into a lot of things that Peach McIntyre sells as far as like her digital information, because a lot of stuff you can Google. But she had a 99-cent special on this particular how to write a book with Peach. And I know how to write a book because I write, But I just wanted to know the process of publishing it and just all of that, because I didn't really know the full process of it. I thought you had to, you know, do certain things. I know you can print out your book and then split it up yourself, but I wanted to make sure I just, you know, I don't know. I just wanted to, and also, I just don't really mind supporting someone just for 99 cents, y'all. That's all it was, for 99 cents. So I've been looking at her, how to write a book, and... You know, all this time that you have on your hand, when you're keeping up drama, some people like to keep up drama, you can write a book. She's telling the truth when she tells people stuff. A lot of people don't like the things that comes out of peach mouth. I'm going to be 100 for real, real, real with y'all. We're going to use astrology. Peach says she is an Aries, from my understanding. Her birthday. Most Aries are just how she is, you guys. Very blunt. Don't really think what they say, because they're just speaking what they feel at the moment. And they kind of put their foot in their mouth a lot of times. She tells you guys the truth at the same time, though. She tells you that she only cares about her kids and her husband. Like her, they get mad at her because they got their feelings. Into who she, you know, you can't be idolizing humans. Like she told y'all, she only do this content creating stuff for a chick. She does not really care. So y'all looking at her and think that you're gonna find your saving grace. You're not. Gonna find it in another human being, okay? Now my daughter wanna know why I started talking about her. I was telling them about the book, mm-hmm. and Peach has and learn how to write with Peach digital thing. Mm-hmm. I was telling them that I write all the time. My daughter is a writer. She writes too, and I ordered that digital thing. She had like a special on it. Give me a second, Serena. No, I ordered it a while back, like for 99 cents, and I already know how to write a book. But my thing was, I didn't know how to do the process of publishing it and all of that stuff. So I just was like, 99 cents. I don't really mind supporting her for 99 cents. That's nothing. And to be honest, I bought her book too.
You can write your book on Wattpad and then get it out there. Like
that's what it's called, Wattpad.
Yeah.
Like Trinity has something she was telling me about called Wattpad. I don't know anything about that. I was just, you know, just wanting to get the book, you know, just put my creative fictional thoughts in the now, basically. Yeah, you can give me that information too, so I can log in and read books, and I also can add my own books as I go.
Okay. If you want to have a separate account, we'll put the account to publish books on.
Serenity went, babe.
This guy doesn't like strawberries.
He doesn't? He doesn't like strawberries? Mm-hmm. But yeah, so the reason why I was talking about her, because a lot of people be getting their feelings about how she is, Trinity. Like, she literally, if you know the lady that said she beat her husband first, I don't know if you, Desmond said that's how he knows. She went viral from cussing her husband out, telling everybody she's gonna divorce her husband after she had her baby because he didn't come to the hospital. She just went viral from drama. And people get mad at her because they be like so invested into it. I'm so happy you leave him because he do this, he did this, he want the womp. But you guys gotta understand, she's a content creator and she makes money from content creating. That's the route she wants to go. But to be honest, you probably know if you see her turn. Everybody know who Peach is. Even Auntie Vicky brought up Peach in one day to me. About how this, she said, it's a lady that's on my, she's on Facebook, she's viral on everything, TikTok, Facebook, everything. This girl, she said she came up on my feed on Facebook cussing out her husband and saying she's gonna divorce him, and then the next minute, girl, she right back with him. And my auntie figure don't even be in that kind of stuff. I was like, you talking about Peach? And when I showed her, she was talking about, she was like, yeah. So she's doing what people like. To be honest with you guys do not like looking at nobody's channel for a long haul if it's positive. If Peach just posts positive stuff all day, every day, or anybody else just posts positive stuff all the time, be interested in it no more. You don't even want to look at it no more. You like, okay. And then you start trying to find some things. If you don't see no negative stuff going on, you try to like put two and two together and try to figure out some stuff. Be like, well, she must not even really be that way. She must have this, she must have that. So she knows that's what y'all like. She says it. She's like, you know, you can unsubscribe and you're still gonna come back and watch. And that's what y'all do. Y'all come right back and watch. But I'm not here to talk about the fan part of it. I'm just talking to y'all about on my blog as far as what I plan on doing with my consistent. I want to stop starting things and not finishing them, because it becomes a ricochet and it bounces off you and bounces on your children. So I always like writing poetry. I always like writing books. I love reading fictional books. I love reading poetry. I love going to, when you guys watch my channel, you see me go on a date night with myself and took myself to a poetry reading. So there's gonna be more stuff like that on my channel, because that's something that's genuinely me. I enjoy doing it. I write music, I know how to do stuff like that, so yeah. So I'm just telling my daughter before she got out to go to the birthday party that I read a book and I finished the book, Butterfly by Ashley Antoinette, and it had me in a whole bunch of emotions. And I was just like, she is good with this writing, because she went from that to, but yeah, so I can't wait to the next book. And what's the name of the app that you said it is, stranger? What's the name of the app that you say you read your books on?
Wattpad.
That's where Trendy goes and read her books. She said those are more authentic writers. They're just starting to write, and they go on there and they start like a whole series, and a lot of people go on there and read. So if you are like myself, want to start out with your writing and getting people to like your write, the way you write things, go on there, and then you can move on to making a published book. But yeah, so we're going to head on home, and we'll be ending the vlog with us eating. So we'll see you guys later. Peace. The outside got a lot of dirt on there, but y'all see, I had somebody come out to my house to work on my car. My brakes was acting up, and I needed, it was making a sound I didn't like. And I also needed an oil change. Abundance and luxury. I don't have to leave my home. They can come right here and work on my car. And guess what? I ain't got to pay for nothing. Peace, love, and light. See y'all later. Hey y'all, what's up? Today is Tuesday. So I am heading to go get my license, because I had to get my license renewed. My license actually expired in June. Here I am in August, just going to go get them. So I just had to figure out the day that I was off to go get them. As far as like, I had to take Serenity to her first day of school. So I was cool with doing it today. So I hope you guys are having a great day. Happy 8-8 portal. Today is a portal, you guys. A very powerful portal. Lion Gate portal. So, of course, this video is going to be recorded after the process of it. But I have already been talking to you guys ahead of it about what this portal can bring to you. It's a shift. It's a powerful shift. So, make sure that you're manifestation and you're being very conscious on what you're thinking and your subconscious thoughts, because this portal is very powerful, and whatever you're gravitating towards you is going to come to you. And also just a insight to let you guys know that we have a lot of planets in retrograde. I told you about Venus being in retrograde, which is going to cause a lot of confusion in marriages, relationships, friendships, all of that. It's going to be throwing things left to right. So I recommend you to make sure that you're doing offerings to Venus, and just, you know, showing your gratitude for what you have. Trying to just, you know, focus on how you're communicating, because it affects communication, basically. And yeah, so that's why. If you have been feeling a little crazy, feeling like a lot of things is just not right, something is not right, that is why, because a lot of planets are currently in retrograde. But yeah, so it's 10 minutes to 12, so hopefully I'll get out of here fast. Hopefully I'm not the only person. It's not a lot of people that have to get their license today. I can go in, get my license, and go on back out. And go get me and Golden something to eat for lunch, because we haven't eaten lunch. We ate breakfast. Well, she ate breakfast. I didn't eat anything because I wasn't hungry. So I'm going to eat me something for lunch. So we're going to, me and Golden, going to eat lunch together. And then we're going to go pick up her sister from school. But yeah, you guys. So I am feeling good today. I'm not going to lie. I have some moments, you guys. Oh, yes. I have been having some moments. Like, literally just been feeling like, like I'm going through different things. My body has just been going through different systems, you guys. I'm not going to lie to you. I just been feeling up and down, up and down. And I know if I'm feeling this, and I know I do my normal due diligence on making sure that I keep my energy right, I know people that don't know anything about what's going on is really taking in a lot. I know they are. Because we all are human. All right, you guys, let me run into here to get my license, and I will see you guys when I get back into the car. Y'all, we are back. We are back in effect. Like, what's up? What it do? What you want to do? Y'all, I had to take my head wrap off. So I had to wrap it back up. Why was I when I got back to the car? Because you had to take your, you had to have a head, you can't have a head wrap on when you do the picture. Of course, Golden was trying to run off while I was doing all of my business. She didn't sit still. But, so now we're finna go get her something to eat. We are leaving in good timing. Good timing. I went right in there. I never even knew anything about this side of town, courthouse. If it was up to me, I would come to this side of town instead of the one on the other side of town, because I came in and was out, and she was a nice lady. I had to take my picture twice because when I, you know, this is my first time ever. I didn't know that you can wear glasses on your pictures. This is my first time taking it without glasses, and then my eyes kept closing while I was smiling. Y'all know when I laugh, my eyes close real tight. Yeah. If it wasn't raining, I'd drive, pull up on my husband, eat lunch with him like I did last time I was off. Could just do that with him. See if he want to eat lunch. Wouldn't that be something nice to do since I'm off work? Go to his job and see if he would like to eat. That'll be so cute, Ryan. What y'all think? That's all I'm gonna do. You know, me and Golden, I'll go to her dad's job and see if you wanna eat lunch with us. So we will see y'all in a minute. Peace. Okay, y'all, I am back. My husband goes on lunch at 1 o'clock, so it's perfect timing, right? So it's a place right here called Wings Are Kings. They have the best fried oysters to me. I've had fried oysters from different places and I never liked them. Honestly, the only fried oyster place that I liked them, other than, it wasn't even a place, it's the way my mom made them. So they kind of give me a kind of think the way my mom used to make them. I really think my mom used to really shuck the oysters out freshly and fry them. I don't know if that's what they do here or they have a fresh person that provide their oysters, but it's really good. So my husband, I'm getting him some wings and fries, and I got Golden a hot dog kids meal. So, but she is knocked out sleep. So we're gonna eat lunch with her dad until he goes back to work. And then we're gonna go and get Serenity from school. But yeah, it's just stuff like this, you guys. Like, I know y'all like these nails. They annoy me, y'all. I didn't pop these other three off because when I popped all the other ones off, it hurt it so bad, y'all. And I just said I'm gonna wait till I soak them off. I'm being a punk, y'all, because it hurt it. It hurts. Like it's wiggling a little bit, but I'm scared to go ahead and pop them off. But, and to be honest with you, the reason why I'm letting my nails rest is because my hands have been into a lot of like things, and I don't want the dirt and all that stuff that I use, ashes and stuff, to mess up my fresh set. So that's why I haven't got my nails done yet. Thinking about going to a friend of mine. She just started her nail business. She's been doing nails for a while, but she actually started the business wholeheartedly, doing it full time. And I love the way she freestyles her nails. So I may go to her, let my nails rest until it's time for me to go to see D'Angelo. And then right before I go see D'Angelo, I gotta get a retwist as well. So I'm gonna probably set an appointment up to get my nails done right before I go out of town to see D'Angelo graduate. In the car, we chit-chatting it up. Did you guys see that brawl that happened here? And it's from where I'm from, baby. Alabama, you understand? Did y'all see how those black people came out? Our ancestors came through those black people when those privileged white tea people decided to jump on that man because he was doing his job, because he was black as well. See, I don't like to usually speak this way, but I want y'all to understand that the ancestors are here. They always have been here. But see, we all are getting more connected with our ancestors. We all are now talking and offering things to our ancestors and the Orishas and our gods. And see, they don't see, that's what they're afraid of. Mm-hmm. Because you seen what happened when we come together. I'm gonna recommend y'all to go and listen to the things that people are saying, but I want y'all to listen real clear. I want y'all to listen real clear. I want y'all to pay attention real close. A young lady said that they had just did an offering to Oshun, which is one of the goddesses of the water. One of them, because we have many. The water is all of our riches. Riches and everything are in the water, okay? The day before that brawl. See, what y'all don't understand, what y'all not understanding is, so many people are realizing who we are. We are offering, we are respecting our ancestors, our Orishas, our gods, our goddess. Yeah, we are. And we're being blessed. That wasn't just us black people ready to just, that's, I gotta talk about it. Give me a second, let me pay for my food. Okay, you guys, I got the food. It's all good in here too. But like I was saying, yeah, she had just did an offering to the water god, one of the water gods, goddesses. And that was supposed to happen, because let me tell y'all something, water got memory. And that same riverside is where the slaves were dropped off. Some of our slaves, some of our people that were slaves was dropped off there. And we are not our ancestors. I say that all the time. We had some fighting ancestors. Now, I don't want y'all to think that we didn't. But see, our ancestors had to deal with it because they was afraid. We not. You understand me? And the fear that they gave, they already learned their lesson. They was there. They already was there. They learned their lesson. They telling us, they showing us, y'all ain't gotta be scared no more. Knock their heads off. Get a chin, crack their head open. You understand me? Mm-hmm. Did y'all see that boy jump in that water and swim? Did you see him swim, baby, limping it? Swim to go help a man that he didn't even know, baby, but he knew that he was of us. He was of our essence. He was of black. So I'm not, I don't have no problem with any other races, but I want y'all to understand. And other races was cheering us on, baby, because they know that is us being tired, sick and tired. We are not your punching bags. We are not your pieces of trash. You are no longer. See, they don't want me to talk for real. That's why they just made me bump dead and knock my phone all day. We are no longer what y'all think y'all was gonna make us think we were. We are learning who we are in our flesh, because the ones that has transitioned on is showing us and giving us strength along the way. They are walking, baby, with us. And I don't even care about that. I don't care about all this violence. Well, he hit a woman with a chair. She, did you see her hit the other man? Did y'all see that? Did y'all see her hit that man? let me tell you, I done passed my husband job first. Y'all didn't see her put her hands on that man. Jumping him. Thought they was doing something. Till something was done. Baby, when I seen them black kings jumping off, coming off that damn boat with that skip and them swinging them hands, I knew it was time. Hey! To knock some heads off. I was honored. And I ain't ashamed of saying it. You ain't gonna make me feel like y'all was looking like some animals. You know what? No, we were. We were looking like kings and warriors and queens. Knocking heads off. Yes, God. Now let's get back to what I was talking about. Yeah, this is a piece of me I don't really show a lot. And I wish I was there. I'm going to tell my grandchildren I was there. I'm going to tell my grandbabies I was there. Knocking heads off. And not caring. He threw that head up in the air. That was a salute. A call to the gods. And they all was like, we got you. Baby, play with somebody else. You ain't gonna keep messing with my babies. Y'all already took too much from them. They are the chosen ones. Y'all done took enough. Y'all done took enough from them. All right, y'all. I'm finna go ahead and get off this phone. And now this gonna go on the vlog. I'm not taking this off. This is a piece of me that I want y'all to see. You're not going to beat on my young brothers, my young goddess and young gods and kings and queens anymore. You're not going to keep telling them they beneath y'all. And not only that, putting your hands on them. You're not going to do that no more. And then run afraid and afraid and want to speak bad of us. And then not only that, one thing about it, those people that was on those boats while they was in under the spirits of alcohol didn't know that they people you can't do that no more. They gonna lose business. One of them gonna say he don't care about losing the black dollars, but see, it's power and tongue. And y'all, like I just said, the gods and the goddess are here. The y'all be talking about the aliens. They've been here, but they are here, and they open up portals, baby. They are here. You think you're going to just lose your... You think you're not going to lose... You think you're just going to lose the black dollars. You're going to lose... You're going to lose everything. Look at my man. My man. Thank you to my man. My man. You're going to lose everything. You hear me? This golden hot dog gal. She's asleep. I just want a regular hot dog for her. She really picky. Like, she ain't picky, but she kind of iffy. It's my husband. And what I told y'all I like about them, these are my oysters. So we're about to eat lunch. And I will see you guys later, all right? Peace. Okay, so this is the chicken. I got it boiling. I seasoned it already. I seasoned it with Creole seasoning. Salt, oregano, complete seasoning, black pepper, and I put my bouillon cubes in there for the broth. And I want my girls to eat more vegetables, so I got this soup mix vegetables. It has baby lima beans in there, okra, yellow corn, green beans, cold potatoes, peas, celery, carrots, white corn, yellow squash, and onions. So once the meat, the chicken start getting done, I'm gonna put that in and then put the long rice and go from there. So these are the candles that I got. I picked these orange candles for what I need them for as far as the work. I have to tell you guys what it's for in a minute. I'm having a brain fart. That orange candle, this is for any type of love work, passion moments, all of that. That's going to be an offering that I'm using. And of course, I have green candles for prosperity, you know, wealth, success, things like that. So I'm picking all three of these. I'm going to come back and let you guys know exactly what I need the yellow, the orange candles for, okay? Because I completely having a brain freeze, okay? Okay, I don't know why I was having a hard time remembering why I got the orange candles. I got the orange candles for a boost in confidence, a shift in the energy to make it more powerful. Okay, you guys, I want to first and foremost talk about abundance and how it comes in. As you guys see, I have a brand new refrigerator that just came in. We were having trouble with our refrigerator, and we have us a brand new one. Brand spanking new. What's up, y'all? I just wanted to share some of my candle magic that I'm doing. Doing the 8-8 portal. Well, it's already passed, but I'm still doing magic. I do candle magic for every day. This particular day is for when Thursday, so it's for abundance, wealth, money, luck, contracts, legal, things of that nature. So I basically drew my own sigil, as you can see in the candles, and put my oils and my mix on there. But you see how this candle is like dancing? And then you see how the wax is all filled to the front. All good signs, like spirit is very happy. And I feel a lot, I feel like a lot is coming in. Like I've been showing you guys little by little. I just got a brand new refrigerator. I had maintenance done on my car. They came to my home. I also just got extra money today, unexpectedly. So I just want to let you guys know that anything you speak over yourself, any type of work that you do, it is truthfully in your control. All right, you guys, I'll see you later. Okay, what's up? Hey, you guys.
There's someone behind you.
I know, baby. The same truck that was finna hit that got cussed out. I had forgot you was in the car. Okay, you guys, what's up? Happy Saturday. Today is Saturday. So we're about, Serenity is with me. She's spending time with mommy while mommy run errands. So we're going to get groceries from the grocery store. I'm going to Winn-Dixie because we received a weekly newspaper showing the deals that they have. So I was like, I'll probably go there and see what they have as far as the deals still in stock. And so if I don't find a lot of deals there, I'll go to another store. We also have it's Winn-Dixie in that area, and there's also a Food Giant. So we're just going to restock on food, get things that we need, snacks for them. Trendy does not like eating the school lunches, so I'm going to go and find her some more sandwich meats and bread and stuff and chips to put in a bag, fruits and stuff like that, juices that she can take to school because she does not like school lunch. Now, Serenity does. She eats the school lunch. She talks about it. She just started school, and Serenity's been doing a really good job. I'm so proud of her. She's doing a great job in kindergarten. But so we're gonna see you guys when we get inside of Winn-Dixie. Say bye.
Bye.
Bye bye. We're out
here at Winn-Dixie.
It's no flavor cold.
Yeah, like sparks.
Oh, what is this?
That's Coca-Cola.
Oh, I like Coca-Cola. Wait, I like Coca-Cola.
You like Coca-Cola?
Yes. Wait, is there anything in that Coca-Cola?
What you mean? Sugar?
Wait, what's in this one?
I
We should get this one for next week, but we should get this one for next week, but let's get this one.
I like waffle sauce. I'm gonna try the waffle sauce. Let me get some Alfredo. I'm gonna get some more garlic over here. Buy one, get one.
That's honey mustard.
That's not honey mustard. That's called Carolina Tangy Gold. We're going to try that out.
Yeah. And get some birch sauce.
I think I want to do the Memphis. Can I go
see what this is?
Yes. And these are Pop-Tart Bites. They're a buy one, get one free. So we're going to pick strawberry, and then we're going to do blueberry.
So, you're going to try blueberry?
It's working, okay. Okay, you guys, I also got another BOGO, the Nutri-Grain bars. Golden likes these, and they're good for her, so I like to get things that I notice that she likes that's good for her. So I'm going to get the strawberry flavor.
Okay, come.
Let me show you some. Over here with the fruit. Because they have the fruit cold. So Serenity loves these oranges.
I don't know.
You don't know? I have to wait the grapes.
Should we get pineapple?
I think we should get grapes, because grapes are good for you.
Get the
pineapples, buy one, get one free.
Yeah.
Wait this side.
Yeah.
There's a lot of grapes.
Okay.
The BOGO, they have pineapples, and my children love pineapples, so they'll buy one, get one free. Some of them. Pineapples. Okay. And then I'm gonna find a bag to put it in. Okay, you guys, so I found another deal with the zucchini and squash, $3 each. So I'm gonna get this one with both of them together because it's a squash melody. So I'm gonna get two of the packs that has four of them in there. Okay. Me that she wanted to make sandwiches for school, which is a good thing. I mean, here there's some other BOGOs that I saw, buy one get one free with the meats. So let's see. Trinity likes the black and purple last time I got it. Hold us out for a while. Guys, we are back in the car. Back in the car. For some reason, the Winn-Dixie we went to, they didn't have regular, like, bread. Like, just regular bread like you buy. I couldn't find it. I walked through the whole store. I didn't find the regular bread. So, they had made the bakery bread, but Trinity wants to make sandwiches for lunch. And I just figured that I just get some regular, like, sandwich bread, wheat bread or something, and I didn't see it. So, but I did show you guys the bagel deals. I got bagels, cream cheese, all that type of stuff, because they like bagels, they like stuff like that. We're gonna, and I just had another Abundance flew in. My aunt that sells my oils for her clients, she just gave me a large lump sum of money in my Cash App. I was like, okay. Wasn't even expecting that. Like I said, I've been talking to you guys consistently about being blessed. I have been blessed in so many ways. Brand new refrigerator, didn't have to pay anything for it. Needed maintenance done on my car, my normal, you know, maintenance for your oil change. They came to my home. I didn't have to even leave my home. I was sitting in there working from home while they were outside working on my car. Things like that is abundance to me. And just no worries. On top of me making my regular 9-to-5 money, I'm always consistently bringing in financial growth because I am a business runner, and I also just have people that give me. I really don't ask for anything, but if I bless someone, like bless them with my knowledge, they want to bless me. And it's vice versa. You get what you give out in this world. So I always, like I told you guys, I write my money back to myself tenfold. That's the way I live in life, period. Everything I give out, I know I'm going to get it back tenfold. So if I know I'm giving out good, I know I'm going to receive good. And that's how you should think in life. I'm not saying everybody should always be perfect. If somebody is giving you a hard time, hey, you come at them with a hard time as well, but you don't have to always do that, because a lot of times I tell people, it's been times I have not had to do anything to anyone. God, my angels, spirit guides, spirit, they be at them, you know, like, so it's nothing I really have to do. And I sometimes feel bad. I be like, dang, I didn't want that to happen to that person because they did something maliciously to me. But it was just like, it's out of my hands. So I tell people this all the time, not just for myself. You don't know unless you have a veil over your eyes who you are messing with. Some of us are chosen people. Some of us are the chosen souls to come back on earth. And you don't know that because you're looking through the temple. You have to get that third eye open and realize who has the spirit expert discernment. A lot of times you don't like people because of who they are and their truth. And you don't like that. You don't like that they're comfortable or confident in themselves. You don't know why that person is confident and confident in themselves. So you begin to want to do things to nitpick and hate on that person and thinking that you're winning because you're doing things maliciously, you're gossiping, you're spreading rumors, you're doing things of that nature, and then things start happening to you and you don't know why. You're like, you start wanting to ask God why you sin. I'm not talking about talking to your friends, because a lot of people know how to cover up when they're going through something. I'm saying when you're at home, when you're going through, you don't know how you're going to pay your rent, you don't know how you're going to pay this bill, you don't know how you're going to make it, you don't have nothing to give to yourself. You're depressed, you're drinking, you're doing drugs, you're doing whatever to cope, and you're waking up, you're asking God, why me? But you're still doing those same consistent things. You're doing those same consistent things that you know is wrong. Sitting there talking about people that don't even know they're talking about them, don't even care about you enough to know that you're talking about them. Belittling people, a jealous spirit, anger, things of that nature will take you down through there. So that's why it's like I told people, it's things I have done in my life. I'm not perfect. I got that whooping. I got that pop, baby. I got it back, you know. I was just telling my friend, I was arguing with a girl one time. So at work, we used to, you know, email each other. This was in my early 20s. And I said something so messed up. Because, I mean, I can't remember exactly what she said, but I'm going to tell you how the Most High worked. I don't remember what she said to me, but I know what I said to her. Because God let it kept replaying in my head. I told this young lady, because we were arguing, she wasn't a shapey. She had a very, very, very bad shape. Like, she was, like, long, straight, y'all know. I mean, no hips, no nothing, no booty, no nothing. And I told her, you need to die and do it over again. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. And I'm telling you, my tongue is very strong, y'all. But it's also very strong when it comes to manifestation. I got a strong tongue. That way. Strong tongue. And what I do as far as my intentions and what I do to bring greatness to me and my family and my children. So I'm not just knowing the power at all, you know. It's power in your words, you guys. It's power in what you speak. It's power.
I'm thirsty.
I know that's why I'm gonna go home. I'm gonna take you home and unload the hot car, and then I'm gonna go back out and go get the bread for Trinity. Cause y'all need to get ready. We gotta be at Auntie Vicky's house at 1. So.
And they the drink in the house?
Yeah, I bought soda.
Oh.
You was there with me. Yeah, it's power in your tongue, you guys. It really is. It's power in it.
There's power in your tongue.
Yes, it's power in your words that you say. That's why I always want you to always tell yourself you're beautiful, you are smart, you are whatever you want to be. If you want to be, what you said you want to be, baby?
What I
want to
be?
Mm-hmm. What you said you want to be when you grow up?
A YouTuber.
She said she wants to be a YouTuber. So you want to be like a family YouTuber or a gaming YouTuber or a kids channel? What kind of YouTuber you want to be?
I'm going to have 3 shows. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have a gaming channel.
Okay.
A family channel and a toy review channel.
See? You see how I'm teaching my 5-year-old? You how she's telling you what she's going to have? That's what's going to happen. I am. Those are the things I'm saying. That's why I'm telling you it's power and tongue. You know what you want. So you got to keep speaking that way so you can. And you also got to put in the work, babe. So you got to start working on your channel and doing your toy reviews. And we already been doing that. You've been doing it on Mommy channel. So you're doing a good job. So that's one of the things you want to do. You want to be a YouTuber. And what was the other thing you said you wanted to do? You don't remember?
Oh, make jewelry?
Right. She wants to make her jewelry. She wants her own jewelry company. But she makes jewelry and she sells it. So I'm currently working on that for her and her sister. They're going to come together because Trinity already has her business, which is Trinity Creatives. Where she does tie-dye and she makes lip glosses and hair coloring. And everything is natural. Hair coloring products. And so she's gonna combine with her sister and start making her own jewelry. So yeah, so that's an inspirational and that's abundance to me because it's passing from myself to my children. So yeah, but that's all I'm saying, y'all. It's power and tongue. Make sure you speak greatness. Oh, she wanna say something else. What else you have to say?
Some of the rings are gonna be in grocery stores.
Some of your rings are going to be in grocery stores. Not grocery stores. You mean retail stores?
Yes.
Okay. So there you go, you guys. You speak power over yourself. You speak greatness because you know that your tongue has power. So you speak what you want to bring into the existence over yourself and speak greatness, positive affirmation, and it will come into the now. All right, you guys. Peace. More abundance is pouring in. I'm so ready. I finally got my oil. One of my oils. Seems like it's one of them. My God, y'all. It smells so good. Look, it even has a little money in there. I cannot wait to use it. So these are one of my oils. I also caught one of her sales, so I'm still waiting on that. But I am so excited to get my blessed body oil. I'm through wealth 11. All right, y'all. See y'all later.
I feel it's time we should make up, baby. I feel it's time for us to get back together and make the best of things. Oh, baby, when we together.
Okay. Ooh. Car coming in behind me. So I'm done running errands. Go, Serenity got out the car, baby. She was like, Mom, I tapped out. Can I just go home now? Sure, my love. So I had to go. I don't know whether I was looking good or not, but I could not find like regular bread at Winn-Dixie. Like the regular, like, and Trendy likes to make wraps. Like she likes to do the spinach wraps, the whole wheat wraps, or whole grain wraps. She's very like picky, because I could have got any kind of bread, but I just didn't want to waste my money, because I mean the other kids eat any kind of bread, but if I'm buying it specifically for her to make her lunches, I wanted to make sure I get what I know she's going to make her lunches with and make sure she fixes them. Then I had to go to Dollar General and get the cleaning supplies that we needed to get to clean the house, some more bathroom stuff, you know, just stuff like that. And I had to get her some sandwich bags to put her sandwiches in. And so you guys basically saw what I bought in Winn-Dixie. So there we go. That's all we got to do. She got her sandwiches and her fruits. I got some Nutri-Grain bars. Like, I'm thinking my kids have more healthier options when they eat at home and when they're just going to eat outside, you know, even though she don't want to eat the food at school. They have more healthier options. And vice versa for myself. All of us gonna eat healthier. My husband, me and the kids, everybody. So I'm so excited about my new refrigerator, you guys, because I had an issue with my other refrigerator. My vegetables and fruits were not lasting because it wasn't cooling the bottom of the refrigerator good. So I'm so happy I got my new one. So I'm gonna have fresh fruits, fresh veggies, and all of that jazz. And so I'm excited, you guys. I want to just talk real quickly before the kids get in the car about what's been going on with the AA portal. The energy, if you have been going through headaches, tiredness, fatigue, just feeling that's why. That is why, you guys, the energy, the new earth is shifting. So you're feeling all of that coming, like hitting you like bricks. It's coming in, y'all. And if you have been spiritually aligning yourself, then, you know, you're fighting it a little more. You're able to fight it. Me personally, I just go outside and ground and I meditate, or I do yoga poses. One of my favorite yoga poses when I'm feeling dizzy and when I feel like I have a headache is I think you can call it a yoga pose, but I put my legs up in the air and I have my head laid back like this, and I, you know, breathe, have my legs up in the air, like straight up like this, and I breathe, and that's been helping. And of course, doing the downward dog, that's been helping me. Child pose, that's been helping. Scratching period and getting a lot of sunlight is really helpful with this shift, you guys. And just making sure that you're connecting, you're, you know, acknowledging the gods and the goddess. I'm currently working on getting another shelf made because I want to put up more protecting altars for the gods, the Orishas that I feel have chosen me. Like, you can just feel it. You can. Some people like to confirm it, but you know the feeling. It's something that initiates with you. And I really just want to honor all of the Orishas. So I'm going to have a shelf, get a set up table for my front room area, for my Shango and all of that, so he can continue to keep putting up the barriers around me and my family. And I don't mind sharing it with y'all because y'all don't have to play with him. You know, that's just being honest. You can't play with certain things. If you're in tune, you're in tune. If you're not, you're not. And I just want to say that I was talking to my daughter about, you heard my baby was telling you guys, you speak. She's like, it's power in tongue. Like she knows it because it is. It's power in what you speak over yourself. So talk good to yourself, y'all. If it's hard for you to talk good to yourself, me personally, I listen to positive affirmations. I record myself speaking affirmations to myself. And speaking of that, I am thinking about doing a podcast or start doing more positive affirmations and mantra videos for my YouTube. So that's going to probably be a whole separate, it's not going to be a problem, it's going to be a whole separate channel that I'm going to have to build up. But then again, I might just do it on this channel alone and just make it something people can share. This day I'm going to be sharing mantras and positive frequency music. But yes, I have been going through the same. You are not alone. Everybody has been feeling the same energy. Everybody has been taking the same thing. If you are moving on to new earth, everybody like, what you mean new earth? We all on the same earth. The energy in new earth is different, y'all. And it's a forcement. It's like the frequencies are forceful, and if your body is not, the way it can connect more. Me personally, I fast. I don't eat all day. I drink a lot of water, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people have been thirsty. That's another one of the signs of it. I just drink a lot of water. I've been eating more fruits, alkaline vegetables, and just letting your energy get into that state. I wanted to also talk about something else that happened here. Where I'm from, we get a lot of tornado warnings, thunderstorms, you know, rain, all of that. But this particular night, like, it was like 4 o'clock in the morning, y'all. I kid you not. I'm used to thunder and lightning. I know the sounds. You're going to hear the thunder, and then you're going to see the lightning flash over the sky. Like, my husband woke up at 4. We literally looked at each other and was like, that does not sound normal. The whole sky was blue. And it didn't sound like it was authentically lightning and thunder. It sounded like to me someone was shooting off the lightning and the thunder. But the system malfunctioned and it made it come out increasingly. It sounded like someone was having a war. It's described it on my TikTok. It sounded like, you know, when you go to a fireworks show and they let the missiles up for the fireworks, and then when they do the final finale, it's like a bunch of fireworks that goes up at a different time. That's how it sounded. It was like, boom, boom, boom. That's how it was sounding, y'all. Like the lightning and the thunder was not doing the normal. It didn't seem real. So, of course, I got caught in the rabbit hole because I know about a lot of the conspiracy theory things. But I'd never witnessed it that close up. And I laid across my bed and I told myself I had to use the restroom. And that's another thing, that's something else I want to bring in, you guys, is what, especially with this shift. If you're having to use the restroom more than usual, that's your body releasing. Like, I have been having to use the restroom a lot as far as going to the restroom. So I got up to use the restroom. I have Alexas all over my home. All of my Alexas was lit. Like it was just spinning around lit. The lights wasn't out. The electricity was working. They were just spinning. So I told my husband, I was like, baby, that don't seem right. He was like, so we set up and we just listened to it. And then when it shifted from our area, I looked at our sky had started being blue, but I was looking out the window when I heard it shift into the other parts that was supposed to be going to the different areas for thunder, you know, because it's thunderstorming. It was the same sounds in a different area. But anyway, you guys,
that's just what I'm trying to point out to people when I say the new earth. Like, things that is not real are gonna malfunction. It's gonna have a lot of things that happen that's not Mother Earth, God, the goddesses, the Orishas, the whatever you want to call them, are here. They've been here, but now the portals are being opened more and more, and they're coming in like very strongly. And I just feel like if you're living in this society and your eyes are not open, I can't judge you because it's not probably not your time. I'm not gonna judge you because it's probably not your time. Everybody don't need to be woke. Everybody can't take this. Everybody can't. You can't take it. It's not just sunflowering, smoking weed and singing and dancing. It's the real deal because you see the truth. You know the truth. And you don't feel fear about it. Because you know that this that's happening is for us. Alright, y'all. I am going to go ahead and see you guys later when we go to my aunt's house for the barbecue. And, y'all stay safe. Peace. So, y'all, let me talk to y'all real quick because we're playing music. Ooh, I'm sweating right now. They're listening. I'm hot. Let me talk to y'all real quick because we're playing music. I ain't even record us cooking. But, we just seasoned. Trinity made the macaroni and cheese. I walked her through it. So we'll be showing y'all when the food done in a minute.
Hey you guys, this is the meal. This is Trinity macaroni and cheese. My cousin made broccoli casserole, chicken, baked beans, cold water.